Hello everyone, Edwin here for Star Productions Gaming. Since The Little Mermaid is now playing in theaters, I thought it'd be best if we played a second episode of the Battle series to make up for it. So now, you got a chance, saw a sneak peek of what the movie will look like. Like in my last video. It was in this link in the first episode. But today we're going to play Battle of the Total series, and we're still going to play it in honor of Disney's The Little Mermaid. So, enjoy this video. And you want to see more Santa Sarah commercials? I'll pause it to you if you want to see them.
I don't know where, I don't know how, but I know something starting right now.
So, please don't have a total series.
A revolution is knocking on Gotham's door.
When this whole thing starts, make sure you're on the right side.
Mr. Wayne, thank you for opening your house to us. Together, we will change Gotham. Harvey Dent, Gotham's next mayor, eager to know you.
Vicki Vale, not interested, and reporter for the Gotham Gazette.
Carmine Falcone?
Is the Dent campaign soliciting votes from Gotham's biggest crime family?
Your father knew which hands to shake.
Don't you know not to corner a wild animal? It's dangerous. Bye, Bat.
This is Selina.
The chemicals. Where are they?
We're all being played in, couldn't you?
It's the Waynes.
Well, the Waynes are the biggest gangsters in Gotham.
Right. So, just a reminder. This game series is actually the choices you make, the story set by how you play. And where is it? There it is. So, this game was allegedly scheduled by the Falcon.
You don't have to do this.
Only you now, Master Bruce. I thought I might find you here. The news was upsetting. Someone told me you should see caution this. When it comes to love, I did. I know you come here for solitude, Bruce. You were strong and I was allegations my about his ties to the underworld. This isn't careless, going away. It's all so public and messy. And
Tell me all of this is a lie.
I wish I could. There are no angels in Gotham, Bruce. You have one, you can go ahead and tell them. Tell them all I know now. Shout it from the rooftop. Right in all the skyline. All we had is gold now. Tell them I was heavy. And my heart is broken. All my scars are open. Tell them what I hold.
Certain moral compromise. It's just not possible.
You kept those secrets from me. I'm trying to help you understand.
Then try harder!
Falling out of love is hard. Falling for betrayal is worse. Broken
Bill
trust and broken heart. I know.
Pony of the mind.
I know. Thinking Thomas, all you need is there. Building faith on love and words.
Your father,
empty
Hamilton
promises
Hill and
Falcone, where I know. When all is gone, there is nothing to say. And if you're done with embarrassing me, on your own, you can go ahead. Tell them all I know now. Shout it from the rooftop. Right on the skyline. All we had is gone now. Tell them I was heavy. And my heart is broken. All my scars are open.
This is the first time I've been back here since that night. When the police called me to collect you,
Someone told me I should take caution when it comes to love.
Think back to that night, as hard as it might be to do so. There must be some detail that escaped you.
What would the Batman do with his own parents' killer? The possibilities are frightening.
I take him to jail, just like any other criminal.
But he's not just any criminal, is he? He was stabbed to death in prison. No one mourns for Joe Chill, Bruce. Try to remember, Bruce. Sadly, he was mistaken.
I can't picture him as a criminal. Not the kind I deal with.
In that moment, he was simply your father. Where exactly does the memory end?
With my father pleading, "You don't have to do this." And the gun fires.
And after that? There are considerable gaps in that recollection.
Maybe. Do I really want to know?
Getting you in to see Falcone like this? I don't have to tell you how many rules we're breaking. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm always here for you. But this could land us both in hot water. I pulled all the strings I had with the lieutenant. This better not come back to bite us.
Look, I get that, Howard, okay? And it means a lot to me.
I know it does, Bruce. It doesn't make it any easier. The last time we brushed shoulders with Falcone, the press made us pay. At least tell me what this is about. Look, I'm all for blind support, but I should at least know what I'm getting myself into.
This is a personal matter, Harvey.
Fine, fine, don't tell me. But I hope none of this comes back to bite us. I don't want headlines taking away from my debate with Hill.
Dent, Mr. Wayne, welcome to the GCPD.
Thank you, Lieutenant.
Ordinarily, we'd never let you in to see Falcone, but it must be nice to have a DA in your pocket, Mr. Wayne. Bend the rules whenever you need it.
I realize this is irregular, Lieutenant. I wouldn't ask if there was another way.
I'm vouching for him, Gordon. Trust me, he's one of the good guys.
A good guy who always gets what they want. In my book, there's no such thing.
Nice job bringing in Falcone.
Yeah, that son of a bitch better not get off again.
He's not getting off the hook, Rene. Not this time.
Mr. Wayne, Sergeant Rene Montoya. I just wanted to say, you know, some of us police support you, despite what the media is saying.
Thanks, Sergeant.
We had to put Falcone in the infirmary. Batman practically tore him in half. He's helped us a lot in the past, but if you ask me, he's out of control.
Well, whoever he is behind the mask, Batman's a hero to me.
Yeah, and that's the problem. People are either scared out of their wits or they're trying to copy him.
Well, at least someone's getting tough on these guys. I tell you, I'd rather have Falcone in here than out on the street.
You weren't there, Harvey. You didn't see it. All right, Falcone's inside. You say what you gotta say. We'll be out here.
All right. We're going in. Episode 2. Oh my god. It's... Children of Arkham.
The hell? Bruce Wayne. You must have some clout. My own wife can't get in to see me. Good thing I'll be out of here in a week. It's like a mausoleum in here.
We need to talk, Falcone.
You weren't so eager the last time we met. But then, I knew you'd come around. Especially after the press got their teeth in you. You're your father's son. Yeah, that's right. Tommy and I were close. More than friends. More like cousins. Going back decades.
Did you have something to do with his death?
Ah, so that's what this is really about, eh? The pop digging up a 20-year-old killer.
Two killings, and they were never forgotten.
You and me, we're practically family. I thought you'd have figured that out by now. I'm trying to get through to your dense party. You showed me the door. Got a whole closet full of birthday presents I was never able to give you. It's a damn shame you asked me.
Convince me. Tell me a story about our big, happy family.
There it is. Now I got you hooked. Your father, Hill, and me, we ran this city. Still do. Think through it. Morphine's on the side there. Be a good boy and help Uncle Carmine out, huh? Didn't fall far, did it? You got that Wayne streak. Much better, kid. Thank you. Gesture like that reminds me of your mother. Your father may have been the doctor, but Martha, she had the human touch. Think you got more of her in you, tell the truth. Yeah, there's a kindness in you. You care about people. Even mean old bastards like me.
I lost her so young. I hardly remember anything about her.
She had steel in her, did Martha. She was the only one that ever had a hold on your father.
Until you hired an assassin to kill them both.
But you really think I hired Chill? Sure. I worked with Joe Chill from time to time. Put a button on someone, he'd take him out. But I never ordered that hit on your parents.
So who did?
You can't trust anyone
in Gotham. But before they can talk any further,
least of all those you call friends. Your parents learned that.
Secure this floor! No one gets in or out! Go! Go!
No, no! We lost Falcone! That is not good! The rest, as they say, was history. You want to see the true story of the Frito Pigs? I won't promise to you want to see them. But now let's go back to the story. Came in.
We are in deep shit. I bought us some time, but not much. Word's gonna get out, sooner or later. Why would she do something like this? We had Gotham's biggest crime lord in our grasp. This close, we were this close!
Isn't it obvious? She wanted to shut Falcone up for good.
I mean, this whole damn force is riddled with corruption. Boy. Someone must have got to her, Jim.
It just doesn't make any sense. She'd never do anything to hurt the department.
Falcone's case meant justice for 1,000 unnamed victims. And now it is a PR disaster. How can I run against corruption when our own cops are redecorating the precinct with their prisoners' brains? Listen, we gotta get out in front of this. We gotta spin it as best we can.
Oh boy.
Issue a statement saying that we have the shooter in custody. Details are still coming in and we're investigating. The usual.
Slow down, Harvey. We need the facts first.
The simple fact is she walked in and shot him.
But then we need the complex facts! Like how and why?
Interrupt Harvey and Brooke Dip.
Lieutenant?
Mr. District Attorney? Falcone's lawyer.
Oh, Christ. I can delay them for a little while, but we still need answers.
Tell me if she says anything. I have to know why she did this.
Alfred, Falcone's been murdered.
Good God.
I'm looking into it, but I'll need access to the back computer for anything I find.
Connection secured.
Alfred, I'm gonna try and confirm some suspicions of mine.
All right, scanning.
Her veins still visible beneath her skin. Fresh injection site. That doesn't look like blood. Alfred, I think I found the substance. Analyze and forward me the result.
Of course. I'll be in touch as soon as I have the results.
Where am I? Mr. Wayne? What's going on? home, but I got this awful feeling something terrible happened. Oh, everything is such a blur.
Easy, easy, Sergeant. Gordon and I are going to get you through this.
Through this? Oh, God. Falcone, what have I done?
I believe you were drugged, Sergeant.
It would explain a lot. Listen, you have to believe me. I talk big about hurting thugs like Falcone, but I would never, never betray the lieutenant. Everything is so bloody. I remember a sharp pain.
There was an injection site on your neck.
Then I just felt light. Like I could do whatever I wanted. No guilt. No consequence.
You can't always get what you want.
There was a voice in my ear insisting Falcone was gonna get off. And all I knew was that I had to stop that. I had to. No matter what. The reasons why I should've. They were a million miles away.
Like you were hypnotized? Under some mind control?
Not mind control. More like my impulse control was gone. My anger was the only thing that mattered. I remember a hand on my arm, guiding me like a parent with a child. The voice, it was saying something about revolution.
Cobblepot said something similar.
They came in.
I'm so sorry, Lieutenant. I've let you down.
We stalled Falcone's lawyers for now, but they'll be back. How is she? Did she tell you anything?
Yeah, don't worry about that now.
Someone used her as a weapon, Harvey. They drugged her and sent her after Falcone.
Hey, get forensics in here. Now!
Why wait?
She remembers a voice saying something about revolution.
That's not much to go on.
Now, if you're bringing forensics in, let's get Bruce out.
Yep, and that's what we're doing.
Alfred, I gotta get back to the manor. I've got a lead on whoever's behind this.
Bruce! What are you doing here?
My friends in the GCPD have been telling stories about some kind of lockdown?
The press can't seem to leave me alone.
Yeah, well, I don't know what to tell you. Maybe it's your cologne. Word is there were shots fired near where Falcone was being held. Know anything about that? I mean, you must have been back there when it happened.
Where did you get that?
So it's true?
No, I didn't say that.
Listen, I owe you for those files on Falcone. I got a lot of credit at the Gazette for that story. Whatever's going on here, you can't afford to be associated with it. Let me help you. I can keep your name out of whatever we print, but you need to give me something I can use. Who fired the shots? A cop? I can tell by the way you're brushing me off that something happened. Just give me something to run with.
A police sergeant. The name Montoya.
Wait, Sergeant Montoya?
You didn't get this from me.
And we're out. Right. There's only one way we're gonna do this. We're gonna stop Nadir. You're gonna go Nadir.
Either Cobblepot drugged Montoya himself, or someone else is using his revolutionary rhetoric. Either way, I need to find him. Let's put our drones in the air and start a search. I'll run a trace on his cell.
In the meantime, we have to find out what we can do about this drug.
The computer's been analyzing the chemicals from Montoya's bloodstream.
Throw that up on the monitor. The residue I scan on Montoya is similar to the nerve agent I found at the docks. Let's see what we got.
It's ironic that Falcone died at the hands of someone drugged with his chemicals. Who'd have guessed that how he'd meet his maker? Prone in his sick bed, surrounded by police who were ordered to protect him.
Murder at the hands of Montoya. That's not justice.
Whoever did this was judge, jury, and executioner. No one should act as all three. I hope he told you something before he was killed. What did you learn from him?
He backed up what you told me. My father ran the city, with two of the worst men in it.
If they were working together, it's strange Falcone had him killed.
It wasn't Falcone who called the hit.
Yeah, well, I suppose that makes sense. Your father, Hill, and Falcone would have balanced each other out.
Computers pinpointed reference points on the two compounds. The men at the docks were doused with the base chemicals. The reaction was messy or out of control. This refined drug is like a weapon. It only took a small injection to strip Montoya of her moral filters and make her act on her base impulses. Both compounds seem stable, but they're quick to fall apart. Whoever processed it knew what they were doing.
What could the creators of such a drug possibly have in mind? Fighting your wars is one thing, but dragging others to fight them for you? Oh.
As far as I know, Montoya is still an isolated case.
Your drones are in position to triangulate Cobblepot's location. Speak with him, Bruce.
Bruce Wayne already tried talking with Cobblepot. It's time he met the Batman.
Yeah.
Kill people will be doing much of anything.
Let's move.
Come check out his office.
Expect a word of thanks from Gotham's number one vigilante. Oh, don't worry, I'll pass your gratitude on to those who made it happen. They'll be pleased to know you think so highly of their work.
You used an innocent cop to do your dirty work. I know how you've been using the drugs you stole at the docks. Where are they?
Is this about Falcone? We all saw how you felt about Falcone. Impaling the man on live TV. If you were truly the defender of this city, you'd have finished the job yourself. And Falcone deserved to die. Vermin like Falcone, they deserve to be stomped out. Believe me, I know from personal experience.
Falcone had it coming, but that doesn't mean you're off the hook.
I like your choice of words. You know how to create an impression. As a show of good faith, I'm gonna let this one go. How's about we talk this through? We helped you with Falcone. Now, if we could just cut out the rest of the rot, like Wayne and Hill, ordinary folks might be able to breathe.
Oswald Cobblepot, what is it about this place that attracts criminal scum like you?
Gotta admit, you've got flair! Here's the thing. I actually admire you, Batman. We both want the same kinds of things. Me and my people, we've got big plans for Gotham.
They found Catwoman.
What do you want with her?
We had a deal. She didn't make good on it. So sorry this didn't work out, mate. I'd stay and watch. I would, but I still got a Catwoman problem to deal with. Oh, what's her name again?
Selina.
Yes! Oh, beautiful name.
He's all yours. ABC, Indy on NBC, and Charlotte on Fox. Tune in this Sunday to watch the biggest day in motorsports. Only on ABC, Fox, and NBC. Now, let's get back to the game of Batman the Total Series. That night, Bruce stripped his suit and Cal and Chop went himself to step down. Hmm.
here.
Here?
Oh, tunes for drinking, dancing, and fighting. Not necessarily in that order.
As Harvey Dent backer Bruce Wayne comes under fire for alleged corruption. Joining me live is Mayor Hamilton Hill. Mr. Mayor, you said earlier today that in light of the allegations against him, Bruce Wayne should distance himself from Dent, but that was unlikely to happen. Why?
He strikes me as of a jealous sort. Very possessive of his toys.
Better keep a low profile.
All right. Time to replace the bartender.
You lost? Because I don't have time for tourists. Looks like you walked into the wrong bar.
Yeah, I'm looking for a woman.
You wouldn't be the first.
Selina Kyle, I'm told she practically lives here.
Selina, huh? You don't strike me as her type.
You'd be surprised.
Hey! Don't I know you?
Don't I know you?
It is you! I knew it!
Cops take all your fancy clothes? Are you trying to lay low?
Of course.
You're not really the low-lying type.
Nice to meet you.
Frank!
Yeah. Funny seeing you. Here.
So much in the papers. Whole other thing, meeting the man in real life. You're shorter than I thought you'd be.
Leave him alone, Frank. Man's just trying to have a quiet drink.
He didn't seem to mind the company.
But
whatever.
Selina, I need to tell you something important.
You're the light, you're the night, you're the color of my blood.
You were supposed to take care of her.
You're the pain, you're the only thing I want.
Instead, you just pissed him off.
Never knew that it could mean so much.
That's why I'm here. You're in danger.
I've had rats on that table all day.
You're the fear, I don't care, cause I've never been so high.
Follow me through the dark, let me take you past the satellites.
You've got to be kidding me.
You can see the world you brought
you
to life. To life. You so love me like you do. La-la, love me like you do. Love me like you do. La-la, love me like you do. Touch me like you do. Touch me like you do.
I only know touch.
What are you waiting for? Fading in, fading out. On the edge of paradise. Every inch of your skin is the holy grail I've gotta find.
I'm not surprised.
Only you can set my heart on fire.
He's right, Barge.
I'm Betty Thompson.
I'm Betty Thompson. I'm Miss Oklahoma here in Las Vegas at the Planet Hollywood Resort and Casino. I'm here hanging out with the Express crew. It's been an amazing time. Picked out my dress for the opening number.
You care about your own skin?
Question.
She's
it's been
with
a
me.
Wonderful time, and I'm
That's
enjoying every minute.
Get him.
I'm Betty Thompson. I'm Miss Oklahoma here in Las Vegas at the Planet Hollywood Resort and Casino. I'm here hanging out with the Express crew. It's been an amazing time. Picked out my dress. It's been an amazing time. Picked out my dress for the opening number for the onstage question. It's been a wonderful time, and I'm enjoying every minute of it.
Come on, this way.
And we're out at Stack Deck.
Negative!
Negative!
Let's check the
other side!
Are we
alone? Yeah, we're real alone.
Oh, brother. Kiss the girl. Here's the good part. But...
let's get out of here.
We're playing.
I'll take the rooftops. You take the alley.
Wait. Just stay out of trouble.
Now, where's the fun in that? You shouldn't trust me, you know.
Alfred, I'm uploading the contents of a smartphone to the back computer. Check to see if there's anything on the phone we can use.
Processing it now. Is everything all right? There are quite a few police cars convening in your location.
It's fine. Has the back computer found anything yet?
Bruce, there are a number of messages here. All from Mayor Hill.
Mayor Hill?
The last voicemail is his. Listen to this.
I gave you everything I have. Wait. I've held up my end of the bargain, and I expect you to do the same.
This is very shady indeed. Whatever they're talking about doesn't sound good.
I should have guessed. What else is on there?
Looks like they're in contact many times.
If Hill's talking to Penguin, he must know something. It's time I paid him a visit.
I agree. The mayor must have answers, but if I may offer a word of advice, The whole world was horrified at what Batman did to Falcone. You terrorized the mayor, too. You could lose Gotham's goodwill completely. And again, Batman's methods would certainly get him talking immediately. Bruce would have to depend on his guile to loosen Hill's lips.
Let's try the first option. Going as Bruce.
Going as Bruce is the smart choice.
Let's pretend we're friends, and we like to get back.
Sorry, the mayor's busy. Do you have an appointment? The mayor's doing debate prep. He really can't be disturbed right now.
Well, I was really hoping you'd be able to help me out. Who knows, maybe I could return the favor one day.
It seems you do have an appointment, Mr. Wayne. Silly me.
And we're in. Here goes. Undercover. Undercover.
Bruce Wayne.
Undercover.
Finally, you've come to see me. Of course, only after your name's been dragged through the mud. Don't get me wrong. I'm glad to see you.
We can be friends, Hill. I'd like us to put aside our differences.
It's easy to ask for peace when you've already lost the war. But I won't be the one to deny a fresh start. Your father and I, we took this city and made it ours. Falcone too, rest his soul. We built everything we have. You were born with it. A young man like you wouldn't understand what it takes to rise to the top.
Oh, I understand. Very well.
Here goes. Let's play.
I gave you everything I have on Wayne. I've held up my end of the bargain, and I expect you to do the same.
Sounds like me.
It is you.
So, what's your point? I take it you have one. Or are you just fond of my dulcet tones?
I'm here as a friend. This can disappear.
Oh, let me guess. There's a fee.
The fee is full disclosure on your partners.
Partners? I want nothing to do with it. I'm in Kalapod's crosshairs, same as you.
But you fed them dirt on me.
Only the files I seized from Wayne matter. Your father, Falcone, and I, we had ways of getting anything we wanted. How do you think your family got the land for Wayne Tower? Cobblepot wants retribution because we took his family's land. Oswald's family signed it over to us, along with the rest of their assets.
If that's true, then Oswald has a right to be angry. Is there any proof?
Your father and I hid our tracks quite well. There's so much more I could share, if only we were friends. I could help you deal with Penguin, let you in on some family history. But I'm caught in a dogfight for my political career, and my rival has bottomless pockets. Now, if that rival were to, say, drop out, or his advertising spend were to dry up, I might have a lot more resources for helping a new friend.
Fine. That's what it takes to earn your friendship.
I knew you'd see the light. It's time we really talked. Power is an old oak. The trunk stands strong, but it's the roots that hold it up. And the thickest of them lead to Arkham.
Arkham Asylum.
Your father, me, Falcone, we used it to get our enemies out of the way. Drugged and declared them insane. It made it easy to take their things. Thomas was the doctor. I leveraged my political power to ease the transfer of assets. Falcone was the muscle. He had his own way of making problems go away.
So that's what Oz wants to punish me for.
His mother was one of our last
patients. You can hardly expect him to think rationally. Gotham was chaos before we took control. At least now there's a semblance of order. Listen, Bruce. Now that we're back on the same side, your father's last gift to me. They're yours. The keys to the city.
Thank you.
Hamilton. Call me Hamilton. Penguin's gathered quite a few victims to this crusade. But that's a problem for another day. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to prep for the debate. My door is always open, Bruce. Next time, make an appointment.
Whatever deal you made with Penguin, he won't honor it.
Don't worry about me. He's not the first to take a shot at me.
Alfred, get a warning to Gordon. Tell him to increase security of the debate. Hill seems to think he's safe, but Penguin's still out there.
Yep.
Is all here.
As per your request, Lieutenant Gordon has tripled security at the debate.
Thanks, Alfred.
It's a plan of the old Monarch Theater.
The auditorium where the debate's being held. I hacked into the image feeds from the security cameras at the auditorium.
Just to be safe.
Just to be safe.
Hills, details about your father. They must have been quite upsetting. I can't imagine how he must feel. To learn so much in so little time.
To be honest, Alfred, nothing can shock me anymore. Not when it comes to my parents.
I wish I felt the same way. But I suppose no good can come from wallowing. The city needs you now more than ever. I'll leave you to it there.
Check the updated codex first.
Gotham District Attorney Harvey Dent appears to be hitting some potholes on his path to the mayor's office. Despite the backing of billionaire Bruce Wayne, rumors persist that the candidate is having trouble paying his campaign staff and making ad buys. A Dent spokesperson said these rumors are nothing more than a smear tactic, perpetuated by the incumbent Mayor Hill's campaign.
In other news, nobody goes to Gotham's dive bars expecting a quiet night out, but police say a brawl tonight at the Stack Deck Bar in Lewisburg was the rowdiest one in recent memory. Reports say multiple arrests were made, with all the suspects taken into custody while unconscious. Police are seeking unidentified men and women who were seen in conversation with the assailants shortly before the fight.
Gotham District Attorney Harvey Dent appears to be hitting some potholes on his path to the mayor's office. Despite the backing of billionaire Bruce Wayne, rumors persist that the candidate is having trouble paying his campaign staff and making ad buys. A Dent spokesperson said these rumors are nothing more than a smear tactic perpetuated by the incumbent Mayor Hill's campaign.
In other news, nobody goes to Gotham's dive bars expecting a quiet night out, but police say a brawl tonight at the Stack Deck Bar in Otisburg was the rowdiest one in recent memory. Reports say multiple arrests were made, with all the suspects taken into custody while unconscious.
Wait a minute. The images on these cameras haven't changed. Something's wrong.
Penguin's men may have commandeered the cameras on their end. We could just be looking at
what they want us to see. Warn Gord that he may have visitors. I have to get down there. Now. Harvey needs to get out of there.
Glad you called. I needed to talk to you, actually. Something's come up. Something that's... well, it's not exactly pleasant.
Why? What happened? Are you all right?
Me? Oh, yeah, I'm fine.
Oh, you mean because of this Penguin threat? They have me in some back room until the debate begins.
For my own protection, they said. A bit of a kill, if you ask me. Look.
Bruce. I didn't want to do this over the phone, but...
my advisors are telling me that I need to...
that I need to
distance myself from you. Until all this mess with your family blows over. They're afraid it's not a very good optic.
Ouch, Hardy. Talk about a sucker punch.
What with the allegations in the press, and now this mess with Falcone, you're a liability. But here's the thing, Bruce.
Without your money...
I am dead in the water. I know this is a delicate topic, but I need you to keep me afloat.
I may have to trash you in public, but you and me, we'll know the truth about our friendship.
You've got some nerve, Harvey. Either we're a team or we're not.
Of course we're a team, Bruce. Of course we are. Just...
not in front of the press.
Listen, I hate to push you, but
I need to know. Can I count on your money, Bruce?
Whatever it takes to save Gotham, that's what we wanted.
I'll always support you, Harvey.
Oh, thank you, Bruce. Thank you. You don't know how much this means to me. To Gotham. I'm sorry, Bruce. The makeup person is here. Guess she needs to put on my face.
I hope you can still watch the debate somewhere. No matter what I have to say tonight, remember.
You are always my friend.
Quite so far.
I've got a feeling that's about to change.
Just so we're clear, you and me, we're on shaky ground.
Jim, listen.
No, listen to me. The excessive violence, it can't go on. Most of the GCPD already think you're a monster. Don't prove them right.
I'm sorry for putting you in a difficult spot, Jim. I value our working relationship.
So do I, Batman. That's why I need you to rein it in.
We have bigger things to worry about right now. Your security has been compromised.
I've got patrols on every door.
You better check on them.
There's 7x10. We're gonna need some help.
I'd keep that holstered if I were you.
Get it!
What's she doing here? She was part of that robbery at the mayor's office.
Really? You're gonna drag out that dead horse?
I think she's mending her ways.
Oh, he's right, Lieutenant. I don't do the bad things anymore. Unless it's on request.
This better not come back to bite me. Alpha Patrol, come in.
That, incident in the bar. Dead is its own kind of cage. I can't stand being in it. Not that I needed your help or anything, but you had my back. I thought I'd repay the favor.
You know, like you scratch my back, I cut some people up.
Doing the right thing. Maybe there's hope for you yet.
Don't read too much into it. I'm just allergic to owing you anything.
None of my men on the ground are responding.
Enough waiting. We're going in.
Alpha, do you read?
Now, aren't you glad I'm here?
Now you have a better shot than my SWAT team of getting in there quietly.
We are seriously underfunded at the GCPD.
Sounds like a vote for death, Lieutenant.
And we are going in.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our live debate for the next mayor of Gotham City. This is an important debate for these two candidates, incumbent Mayor Hamilton Hill and a challenger, Gotham District Attorney Harvey Dent. And it's also important for you, the citizens of Gotham, who will soon head to the polls to decide the future of your home, a city that's been
we know why they weren't responding.
Gordon, we found one of your patrols. They've been terminated.
As you might have guessed, there's been a change to tonight's program. First order of business, firing the moderator!
I hate to be a downer, but these hostages, I don't like their chances.
Casualties are inevitable. It's only a question of how many.
Inspiring. You really know how to pep a girl up.
You'll do. Get out of here. Keep it quiet back there.
These guys are armed to the teeth.
We need a new moderator.
Come on, you.
You there. Yes. You. Thank you for volunteering.
Wait. Please. No.
Go on, then. Introduce the candidates. Stage fright, huh? All right. I'll get you started. But this is your show.
Three hostiles. Gotta take them out quietly.
do this quickly.
Sounds fun.
Be ready.
Make for the police line.
Oh boy.
And now, a word from our sponsor.
My downtrodden brothers and sisters of Gotham, you have nothing to fear. We are the children of Arkham. We are here to end the masquerade and expose the corruption at root in your city. For too long, men like your esteemed mayor have profited from the pain of innocence. Tonight, we show you the truth.
This is spiraling out of control. They have no idea about the man behind the mask.
Whoever it is, they're smart. Let someone else get their hands dirty.
Look into the hearts of these spineless creatures, chosen to
lead. Good enough. You know what to do.
Take off your masks! Show Gotham your true selves! Tell them what you really think about the city!
Everybody in Gotham saw that moderator get shot on live TV! What's going on in there?
First off, we should insert!
Thank you.
your state!
Thank you.
news spread out, basically.
City Hall is in chaos after Mayor Hamilton Hill was confirmed dead.
While several members of the Children of Arkham have been arrested, the Penguin is still at large.
Yeah.
Wayne family scandal continued to escalate after the full list of Thomas Wayne's victims was released to the public.
Mr. Wayne.
Lieutenant.
He's lucky. Could have been much worse if a bad man had been there.
But there's still going to be scars.
Yep. Scars it is. Please, episode 2.
Next time on Batman, the Telltale series.
Batman, save me. I know this isn't over. Who are these people, Bruce?
Authorities are scrambling. The so-called Children of Arkham have the city in a frenzy, but there's still no sign of their masked leader. With Hill and Falcone dead by their hands, the question on everyone's lips is, next.
After that news about your father sending innocent people to Arkham, sounds like the whole city wants your head on a pike.
The Waynes have always run this country, but now they want to decide what your future in this company will be.
Do you really think Bruce Wayne is worth protecting?
But don't worry, Bruce Wayne's finally gonna get what's coming to him.
Bruce! Bruce!
And we'll see you next time.